into the love letter this morning. We're going to get into further conversations coming in from, of course, the immunization that is happening, the massive immunization that we are having a chat about as far as rubella, polio, measles is concerned. Now, this morning, we're also going to be joined by a health inspector coming in from KCCA. She goes by the names of Rubambula Juliet. Good morning to you.
Good morning, sir.
How are you doing?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
Very fantastic. It's good to have another mother on the show. I must be safer than any other day.
You're a baby now.
No offense to my fellow men, but now I'm a baby. Yeah. So we're going to be still looking at, you know, this massive immunization that is being carried on as far as, you know, serving our children is concerned. I think, Imi, I want you to chip in here faster with a couple of, you know, points representing the parents and pregnant women.
Okay, when it comes to immunizations far and wide,
wala nti abantu babera balina okuyiga ne basiima nti immunization nyingi nyingi era nnungi nnyo ku bantu ku bulamu bwaffe because I remember in 1991 there was mass immunization against polio. There were very many people dying from polio. There was measles nga byo bya ddala abasinga tebaabira banako twasoma nnyo kira diseases zino naye tuze dynamics zikyuka environment ekyuka obulwadde bungi nnyo obukola ki obujja bukulaakula mu bantu. So we find ourselves that the health sector is paying attention to us worldwide. Naye ate nga advantage esinga okulwanyisa obulwadde businga it's easier when it is with the kids, especially with the contagious diseases.
Yes.
Kati nze omukyala nsaba asooka mbuulire. When it comes to rubella, kyensomyeko nti it is most dangerous when it comes to a woman who is pregnant. Nti asobola okugispreadinga ku mwana gw'agenda okukola ki? Okuzaala. Are we arranging for the pregnant women nti nga bwe tugenda ne batukuba tetanus? Ne batukuba tetanus. Are we going to also curb this? Because if it is exposed out there, that means it's a risk for.
It is indeed a risk. What we are going to do, together engaging other pregnant mothers when they come up for antenatal to prevent the transmission from the mothers to the children. By this time round, we want to engage all the age between 9 months to 14 years before the childbearing age. We assume that at 14, maybe someone has not yet conceived, although there are some few cases, and then we shall boost the immunity against the measles or rubella.
So where does that leave, you know, the pregnant mothers right about now?
Right about now.
When you have this massive immunization that is happening for the children.
For those 15 and below.
Yes.
For those 15.
So for now, the pregnant women are on hold.
Yes, they're on hold.
But can they get the vaccine in hospitals? If, you know, one went to the hospital, can they get the vaccine administered?
They can
to
get
them?
The vaccine. Both in public and private hospitals.
Okay. Now, I am a mother, and I am at, let me start with the one who is away from the kids. Are they going to go around scouting for these children, or are they going to be based in a place in Chiyabano, we now call a Chikubatuado? Kule kabana abe somero, tugamba buno busigade waka, nebayaya.
Katuchetu kole saweno, ngatucha alima somero, ngatugema, tuinaba sawa faboku biyalo, whom we refer to as VHTs, village health teams. We've already given them registration sheets, and we assume that they are known in the areas where they stay. So they are going to house, registering those children who are not going to school.
Okay.
So on Saturday and Sunday, we shall be stationed outside schools in different villages, and we shall provide a service unto them. The VHTs will continue mobilizing these people from their houses.
Okay, to make sure I've understood you, the VHTs right now, in the absence of the parents, are just going to their homes, registering these kids. So on Saturday and Sunday, when the parents are assumed to be home, they carry their kids to these centers to get immunized with their consent.
Yes, with
so,
their consent.
So, chitegeza, banji, by the way. Bagena tambu, ya mubantu, bagamba, sifetuze kugema, kati kansa, ngasina kuwa warning. Otegeza, which tags do they have? How are they presented? Wamba de overcoat, bali mukala chi, bali na IDH.
So those VHTs, bamanyidwa in their villages, because they operate within those villages. Number two, we've given them T-shirts, which talk about immunization,
Zakarachi.
And with the label VHT, they are grey
T-shirts.
When they are engraved red, that these are VHTs. So they are going to different home states.
Do they have IDs?
They, apart from the national IDs, like KCCA does not offer IDs to the VHTs.
We could have given them.
We assume that they are known in their villages because the procedure of selecting these VHTs is through the village meetings. And they keep on advising them day by day on the health-related issues. So when someone comes to your homestead, that person is not new to you. And besides that, you've added on the T-shirt and even the Mavisos campaign, the advert, the mobilization is everywhere.
So for safety also, VHT abai no kutambulirako no wa cancer mlalo wo ku kyalo tagenda kuba yekka. For safety of homes.
Oyo VHT wa ku kyalo ko.
Abantu bamumanyi
besa. Agenda kuba yekka.
Ngabo inzo kumanya cancer
lawo. Ngabo kuba yekka. Kubanga yalondebwa mu lukiko lwe kyalo. Ne cancer amanyi ne elsa amanyi. Kati wajje wo bela wa mulaba ko da. And what besides that, what is telling you is not on YouTube because you've had it over the radio, over television, and everywhere.
Wali yaka sente ketuwayo, manyi wa inzo kujate na
watu sente meka.
Yo mtwalo for registration.
Mukugema kuno.
Mukugema kuno.
Mukugema kuno. Byonna byabwerere.
Byonna, never VHTs. Naye
atenge eddagala ddamu, era lijja kukola. Never VHTs, toba wayo wadde n'ekikumi.
Kati ng'omuzadde, omwana wange nga bamaze okumugema. Rubella, mizozi, ne polio. Kiki mba nsuubira nti omwana agenda oba kulwala afunemu akasujjasujja akololemu okw'ennaku nga ssatu. What are the side effects?
Kiyinza okusinziira ayinza okufunamu ka temperature katono. Obeerawo okugamba oyinza okukakanya ka temperature n'omuntu akakuba katikangabe ng'ekiwero ng'ekyo naye kaba kajja kuvaawo amangu ebbanga eritali lyewala n'aba nga addamu okuba obulungi. Of course ne wano webafubise wayinza okuba wamuluma.
Wakunyiga oba just wakuleka.
Ati wakunyiga kati olwo musawo oli akubyewo akayiso ateekawo kapamba. Anaabeera kati asobola okukwatawo ko okumala eddakiika omusaayi gwine guba nga tegukyajja.
Katika pamba weka wetukira ngomkono tugureka.
Ngomkono tugureka.
Okay.
Some parents have come up to you, especially in rural areas, you know, they are kind of having these methods going around with the vaccines, saying that they are dangerous. I mean, we read a story whereby some parents are attributing this vaccine to the cause of autism in their children. Why is that so? Why do we have, you know, that kind of feedback coming in from rural parents?
Of course, those are misconceptions. You know, people have different attitudes. Some people, they actually focus on those myths and so forth, and maybe precedences. Some people know that even without immunization, especially the elderly parents, they think even without immunization, the children can live.
Okay.
And they also, there is that phobia, maybe that when when immunized, my child can suffer from that. But we are assuring them, even this morning, as people are watching us, that these vaccines are safe and free.
Okay.
And they will do good to our children.
All right, well done. Now, as we do get to wrap up, what is your last words for your fellow mothers out there that are watching us right about now?
My last word, of course, is mobilizing, encouraging them to bring their children for immunization, right from zero age to 14.
Derek, I am curious, since it is KCCA, KCCA, yes, epitome vaccines. Kati nsaba n'abantu tubabuulire, vaccines chize mulina era musangibwa wa mbutongolo bwammwe.
Mukugema kuno?
Vaccines and that. Out of Moses Rubella, sorry, out of
measles.
Measles Rubella.
kakati tulina eddagala lyonna ery'okugema ebyekyenjawulo kiriwo nti luli edda twalinga tumanyi endwadde zaffe mukaaga nga ze tugema hupinkopu meningitis mizozi tetanus ne kakati wenjogerera tulina endwadde zeeyongerera ddala obungi kati tulinawo vaccine ya BCG eyo ngekola nnyo ku kafuba tugimanyi teri omwana bayakazaalibwa ne bagimuwa tulinawo eya diphtheria, hepatitis B, nayo bagimukuba, ne bamukuba n'eya polio, waliwo n'eya rotavirus, eyo okubeera nga egema ekiddukano, ne wabeerawo eyo IPV, nayo babeera bagimukuba, waliwo measles rubella. Measles rubella kati eno eringanga bw'oba okola, actually it is a launch. Akati bwe tunaddako tujja kubanga omwana bw'aba azaaliddwa naye eri ku schedule eyaziri endwadde bujoze tugema
kaadi egenda kyuka
kaadi ejja kubanga ekyuka kanaye bajete tulete kaadi ng'eri updated nga kati Measles Rubella kuki kweri waliwo Jetuita PCV, waluo HPV, ya cancer. Tukula tena tena yu, inyo mune mubana, aba wala, aba
wezeza.
10. Waka tuba tuluhoza, nti nino, tuwa njagade, ukujubu umuana umuala, katana baku tukambia kwe gata. Kakati kumia akeju. Tuwa njiluhozeza, nti umuana katana baku bitu kakumia.
All right, there you have it. Now, of course, at the end of the day, as parents, we believe that the future of our children does lay in our hands. So head out and, of course, be part of this massive immunization that is happening within our country as far as, you know, making sure that our children are safe for the future is concerned. And remember, just in case, maybe you're getting to watch us online and you cannot be part of this immunization, probably you're abroad and you are not within the country, you can endeavor to make sure that you come back and, of course, be part of the routine immunization that does usually happen at different hospitals. I mentioned it was in for another short break, but when we do get back this time round, we're going straight to the love letter.